Now I will show you how to create stuck in and stuck out in Microsoft Access. First, we need to create two tables. Okay, let's get started. Open a new blank database. Then we'll put the name. Put in the desktop. Say stuck manager. Okay. So you can write any database name. Now I will hit OK and create. First, we need to go to create, then table design. Now I will put item code number, then I will modify this one, say double, then general. So our default value is 0. Now we will put the caption here and I will put a space. Click save, then inventory. This is our table name. I will delete this one. I use this one as our primary key. Then description. Item price. Then inventory quantity number, and format to put this one as standard. So our default is 0. Check. Still showing dollar. Modify this one. Currency should be standard. Then we put the caption item price. So now we have inventory tables. We'll put some dummy data. 100, let's say bottled water by 30 ml, let's say 15. This quantity we will use our stuck in stuck out user interface. I will show you later. Then this is sardines regular. So now we have our item sample. Next, we need to add another table, which is our inventory transaction table. So, table design, we type trans ID or transaction ID, we make this one as OK. We'll save, then inventory transaction. This is our primary key. I will remove this primary key. Item code number, then quantity also number. So now we have inventory transaction. Now we will create form for this inventory. Instead of direct here in table to write our items or to add items, we will create form for our entries. So again, what I did is just select this one, inventory table, create, then select this one. Instead of a form design, choose this form, then automatically Access will give you a form with corresponding fields. Now we will adjust this one. Auto center, yes. Then record selector, no, no. And we will choose pop up. I'll try. Now we have our inventory form for our entries. We'll save. Now we will make another form for our inventory transaction. Now instead of as what we did in inventory, we'll use here create with form design. Then we'll save this one. Transaction. So this is transaction form. Then we will add a record source, which is the inventory transaction. Then I will add here item code. Then I will insert the combo box. This combo box, we will select the corresponding data based on the item code from our inventory table, which is this one. Next, we just inventory. Now, item code and description is enough. This one. Next. So we'll unhide and we'll show this item code. Next. Next. Then finish. We'll modify this one. Select item. Adjust this column or this list itself. We'll adjust to list width. We'll make it 4. Too much. We'll adjust at least 3. 3 rather. Now we will assign this one instead of unbound. We'll assign here as item code. We'll put some unbound here. This one description. Size itself, description, now this description should be unbound, because here, after selecting this item, example this one, automatically should be the description also showing. So now we will use DLOOKUP here. We'll make a DLOOKUP from our inventory table. This one description. So control source here, click this one, then we will type here equal DLOOKUP this one, and we will type description, which is our field, this description. Logo, comma, our table, which is inventory, double quote, comma, then our inventory field, which is this item code. These are our criteria, item code. Item code is our criteria. Double quote equal then double quote and our field, which is item code from inventory transaction. So whatever item code which selected on this transaction form, automatically it will update our the corresponding description. So we'll type here item code, just hit tab, then close parenthesis, then okay. Here now if I select this one 101, automatically it will update also here. If I select also 100, automatically it will update also. Now I will copy this one for another field. This is for item price. So from here we will modify only, this is item price, just copy this one here, still the same inventory table, because we are look up this one from our inventory table, and same also our criteria, this item code, this is from our inventory table, and this is also our criteria wherein taking from our transaction form. Okay, we check if I hit 101, now it's showing the item price. Okay. And now we will add another field also, but here also we'll check the inventory quantity here. Inventory here quantity, we need to change here, and we will make this one here. We will modify the name of this text box, this quantity on hand. So now we don't have any stocks, so we will put some button or another text box for our entries here. So I will add another text box here. Okay, I will copy this one. And this is quantity. In or out here, and we'll change the name to quantity. And we will delete this. We'll make this one as allowed here. The purpose of this one, example, we have. This one is inventory. So this is our inventory 0. So the purpose of this one, example, I will type 50. Then I will put here a button to add, and I will put also another button to deduct or for stack out. Okay. Now I will add button here. Cancel. I will type here in. Then we will change the command button. CMD in. This button also. I will modify CMD out and caption I will put out. Again, if I choose this 101, then I will put 50 here and click N. Automatically, this 50 we will be added into our inventory. If I put another, if I put also 50, then I will click this out. Automatically, this 50 will deduct to our current inventory.